Trust it.
Hey everybody, Dr. O here. Let's talk about the six major bone shapes. So let's start with long bones. So long bones are going to be long and thin. So these are going to be the bones of your arms and legs, your upper and lower extremities, except for your carpal bones in your wrist and the tarsal bones in your ankles. So your humerus, radius, ulna, metacarpals, and phalanges there in your arms, femur, tibia, fibula, metatarsals, and phalanges in your lower extremities are going to be long bones, so long and thin. Let's just go in order. Next, we have flat bones. So flat bones are going to be flat. The two surfaces generally run parallel to one another. You see the sternum as a great example there. The bones of the skull, your ribs, these would also be good examples of flat bones. So long bones, think extremities. Flat bones, think your skull and then your thoracic cage there. Irregular bones are just like, I have no idea what to call this shape, so we're going to call it irregular. They have very complex irregular shapes. So the example they give here is a vertebrae. Like, I don't know how I would describe that. So it's irregular. The bones of your pelvis, your coxal bones, your ilium, ischium, and pubis would also be classified as irregular bones. Short bones, like the name implies, they're going to be short. They're going to be small and thick little bones. The key examples here are going to be those 8 carpal bones in your wrist and the 7 tarsal bones in your ankles. Then you have sesamoid bones. So sesamoid bones are unique because they're bones that develop inside of tendons. So tendons are supposed to attach a muscle to a bone, but sesamoid bones grow in some of these tendons. Their job is to protect the tendon from being compressed. They also can help kind of change directions. The key example, the only one I'll ask you to know about a sesamoid bone is the patella there, your kneecap, but they can also develop near your thumb, in any other places in your hands and your feet as well. So a sesamoid bone is a bone in a tendon. Tells the only example I ask you to know. The sixth one's not on here. They're called sutural bones. So like the name implies, these small little irregular bones that can develop in sutures between your cranial bones would be called sutural bones. So long bones, think arms and legs. Flat bones, think skull and thoracic cage there. Irregular bones, you have vertebrae in your pelvis. Short bones, think wrists and ankle bones. Sesamoid bone, the patella is the only one I'll ask you to know. And then just remember, sutural bones are bones that can develop inside a suture. All right, those are the 6 major bone shapes. I hope this helps. Have a wonderful day. Be blessed.